The following episode of Dad vs. Daughter was made possible by a contribution from Ravensburger.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Dad vs. Daughter. I'm Tim the Dad.
I'm Megan the Daughter.
And today we are playing Castles of Burgundy. This is the board game version, not to be confused with the card game version.
Yes.
This is by Ravensburger and designer Stefan Feld. Now, how would you talk about this game as far as what kind of game it is?
It's
not area control.
It's like Kingdom Builder, but not. And it has dice.
Does have dice.
And
but there's plenty of ways to mitigate the dice. So the dice doesn't, it's not a random game. Wouldn't call it really tile placement. Although
no,
you are kind of placing little
kind
tiles.
Kind of, but not really.
It's kind of its own beast, I think.
It's a combination that has become its own.
Yeah, so I tell you what, why don't you watch the video and decide for yourself what kind of game it is. The rule book will tell you the introductory games you guys play. You use the number one boards for your estate, which is what we have here. I am actually using number six.
This is number one, by the way.
And number one, all there are four number ones, one for each player, if you want to do that, and they're all identical. However, when you flip it over, they'll have a different number, and that's what I was referring to.
This one is number four, so you have a different arrangement. You're playing with what number?
I'm number six.
I'm playing with number eight.
So we start with one of the castles already on our board. I've chosen mine right in the middle. Megan's chose hers up towards the top. The game is played over five phases with five rounds in each phase. And on each phase, what we're going to do is we are going to roll our dice, and then we are going to use the values on those dice in order to basically take actions and go around to the various areas on the main board, collecting goods or collecting the little six-sided tokens that we will then place in our estate. And we have to match the numbers, and you'll see that there's all sorts of numbers on our player board. So you'll notice that as we play through the game. Megan, do you want to start first? Or do you want me to?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and start first.
So since Megan is starting first, I actually will get two of these worker tiles. And the worker tiles can either add one or subtract one to a die value. Megan will actually start with one since she's a start player. We also start with one silverling, which is the currency in the game.
And, it's like a little nugget.
And we'll get more of those when we sell goods or if we have a mine.
Mm-hmm. And here are some of these good tokens here. And you all start with three. You shuffle them up and you will get three. You won't know which ones you have.
Yeah, I actually have all three the same.
So you'll just place those on your little good spot and you'll have them. So if you have the same color, they'll be in that one hold as well. So you won't separate them.
Right, you stack all the like ones. And you'll have room for three different ones, and then you have a blank space for when you sell items.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll kind of talk that as it goes, because I think the easiest way to show this game is just to play it and kind of talk things through, because otherwise it can be kind of
confusing and overwhelming.
Yes.
There's a lot going on, and there is a lot of iconography, so that is something you do have to kind of get used to, but we will talk you through all of that as we go along.
So you will notice that you'll see like threes and fours. So this game scales 2 to 4 players, and you'll see that we have twos there, so for a two-player game, we'll just use those spots. So Megan, you said you're going to go first.
Yeah, I'll go first.
The player who is in first actually rolls a white die. So we have five phases up here. So at the beginning of each phase, we take a stack of these and we flip them face up. These are all good tiles. And then we are going to roll our dice all at the same time. And that white die is going to determine where this first good goes.
Slot number six.
So you can have as many goods in these are called depots, as you know, incentive for people to buy them, but they can keep piling up over the time. So Megan has a one and a five, so she's going to look and see here, just for clarification, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We have our scoring track, and then we also have our turn order. Since Megan is first, Megan, you'll actually have your token on top there.
Okay.
And when we have boats, you're going to move your token along, and that will determine who the start player is. So I think I've said enough. So Let's go ahead and play. Okay, since the rules say the youngest player gets to go first, yep. Megan will actually get to go first.
Ooh.
Again, shock of shocks. Okay, so she will be rolling the white die uh-huh. to determine where that good is going to go.
It's going to go in spot number 5.
Whoops, that's 6. There's 5.
There we go.
And 5 and a 6.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and go to 4 and take that boat.
You like the boats.
Yeah.
Of course, with your board, that actually is a good thing.
Actually, let's not take the boat from there. Let's take the watchtower from there and use the 1 to take the boat from there.
Well, aren't you the clever one?
Yes.
Okay. So, 5 and a 6. I think with my 5, I'm going to take this mine. And the 6, I'm going to take these 4 cows. Because we like cows. We got cows.
Okay.
All right, that's the end of the first one.
Good on spot number 1.
Okay. Put in the 1 depot.
Mm-hmm. Gonna go to depot 3 and take the bank, I believe. And then use that 5 to put it in my estate. So that means I get 2 silverlings. And then...
Would you like to buy anything from the black market?
Yeah, I am. I'm gonna go ahead and take this knowledge, which I believe you get 1 extra point for each of your animal tiles.
I think every time you place an animal tile, you get an extra.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's kind of nice. I think I will use my 5, and I'm going to take this market, and I have a 6. I'm going to use these 2 workers, make that 6 into a 4, and then I'm going to place my market right there, and my market will allow me to take a ship or a
pasture,
or an animal. So
there's a ship and there's a pasture.
I'm going to take that ship.
Okay.
Okay, that's it.
Depot number 4.
4.
Alright, I'm going to go ahead and use my 4 to put my boat right in there. So that means I completed 1 individual section, so it gives me 1 point.
Yep.
And I get another 10 points.
Yeah, that's nice. With your board having those boats like that,
mm-hmm.
yeah, especially if you can get those small ones done real quick, so that puts you up to 11. This one goes up to 11.
11.
You hungry for some Eggos?
No. I go for fish fingers and custard.
Fish fingers and custard.
Always
got to work that Doctor Who reference in, don't you?
Somehow, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and use my worker and make that 5 into a 6. And I'm going to go ahead and put my watchtower right up there in that little section.
Oh.
So that will give me 4 points for that. And that completes a 2 little quadrant. So that gives me 3 extra points.
Oh, yeah. Because you get 4 points for your watchtower.
4 3 points
for
that.
1, 2, 3.
And then another 10.
Gosh darn, kid.
Ha ha ha.
Well, I do say that you have owned me in this game.
Yeah. Your turn.
Is that it?
That's
all. You want to dig that knife a little deeper?
No, that's good.
Okay. For 1, I am going to place my boat here. So now that I got my boat in play, I can actually take a good.
I should have taken a good. I put my boat in play first, actually.
Yeah, so go ahead.
I'll take that, and I should have moved on the boat track, and you put a boat, so you're actually on top now, though.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to take this 4, a little hate drafting away from you, from my boat there, and then I've got a 3. With 3, I can place my mine. Ooh, where do I want to place my mine? Do I want to place it there or there? I'll place it up here.
All right.
So
that completes a section.
It does complete a section.
So you get 11.
So I get 1 for that, and then another 10.
Woo-hoo. There you go. Alrighty.
Yeah, the damage is done, man. You.
Depot number 6.
Yeah.
I'm going to go ahead and use my 4 and put that knowledge tile right there. And then with my 3, I'm going to go ahead and take those piggies.
Little breakfast buddies.
I do like bacon and ham.
You are a bacon eater.
Mm-hmm.
You're a bacon eater.
Bacon
I'm a bacon eater.
Oh, goodness.
5 and 4.
That was really bad.
Yeah. You know what? Here, I'm going to use my, my 4, and I'm going to place my cows. Right there, 4, and that puts me up to 15. I have a 5 left. I really don't know if I'm going to do anything with that knowledge tile. Because I usually don't go for the knowledge tiles, I feel like. But I am going to tick that.
Okay.
Just because I know that I'm going to need to put some knowledge tiles down sometime. I'm going to need to lay some knowledge on you.
Oh, brother. Depot number three for that.
And...
All right. Okay. Everything's gone out of 5 and 6 depots. And I don't have any workers, actually. So I think I'm going to go ahead and turn that in for 2 workers.
Might as well.
And then use one of my workers to make the 6 into a 1. And go ahead and put my piggies in. So that gives me 2 points for my pigs.
Okay. So I'm going to use my 6. I'm going to do a similar strategy. I'm going to get 2 workers.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to use a worker to make this 2 into a 3.
Okay.
And I'm going to sell my goods here. So that's going to be 2 points for each one of those. So that's 6 points. So that takes me up to 21. And I get a silver.
Nice.
Now, with that silver, I think I'm going to spend both of those silvers and get these piggies from the black market. All right, so that's the end of the first round. So now we score our mines. Do we have any mines?
I don't.
I have 1, so I'll get 1 silver.
Okay.
And we will get rid of the rest of the tiles. The market goods stay where they're at. And while Megan is seeding the board, I will put the new market tiles out here.
Okay. You should have actually been going first because of your boat. I just kept rolling.
Oh, that's okay. That doesn't really matter.
All right.
You got to go first.
You can go first, Nando. We'll keep that.
Okay, so this is going to go into the 3.
Okay.
So I have a 3 and a 1. I can do this. For that 3, I'm going to take this watchtower. And then with the 1, I will place the watchtower. I'm going to place that watchtower up here. That'll give me 4 points. That puts me up to 25. So your turn.
All right. 4 and a 2. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and take that boat from 4 and use my 2 and go ahead and put it there. So I've completed that, so I get 1 point and I get an extra 8.
Yep, 8 points. Because of that. There.
And I get to actually jump ahead there. So I get to go first now.
Yep.
Alright, that will go on depot 5.
And the 2 and a 6.
I got a 1 and a 5. See. Let's go ahead and use the 1. We'll take, I don't remember what that building's called. Oh, the brown roof.
That is, I think, the carpenter workshop.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's going to let you take a building tile of your choice from one of the depots.
Nice. I'm going to go ahead and use my 5 to actually put that into my estate. So then, let's see. I think I'm going to go ahead and take...
You've only got really one option. You've got the marketplace right there.
Or I have the boarding house.
Oh, I didn't see that one down there.
Ha ha. I think I'm going to take the boarding house.
Yeah, you like getting those workers.
You do. Okay.
All right, so my turn. I think I'm going to use that too. I'm going to place those piggies down here. Those little breakfast buddies. And that's 4 points. So that puts me up to 29. And then with my 6... could get some sheep, or I could get another market. Yeah, I think I will. I'm going to take that market.
Okay.
And I only have 1 silver, so I can't buy anything.
Okay.
All right.
Depot number 4. All right, I'm going to go ahead and use my 6 to put my boarding house in my estate. That is a section 2, so that'll give me 3 points. And then another 8 for completing this round. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. My boarding house also gives me 4 worker tiles.
Nice. And you're pulling away.
Yep. So I have my 3 left over here. I think I'm going to go ahead and use one of my workers to make this 3 into a 4. And I'm going to sell my goods here. So that will be 6 points and 1 silver for that. And then I have 2 silver. I'm going to go ahead and spend. And I'm going to go ahead and take the chickens from the black market.
Don't, Daddy Carlos. Don't be cheeking. Which Disney attraction is that?
Yep.
Okay. I saw something that I was going to do.
And you forgot?
No, that's what I'm going to do.
Did I distract you, Terry Blossom?
Yeah, so that's coming out, by the way.
I'm so excited.
So I'm going to use a worker to make that 5 into a 6. And I'm going to use that, and I'm going to place that market right there. That will complete this. So it's a 2. That's going to give me 3 points, plus another 8.
All right, you're at 40.
And a 1. Use the 1, and I'm going to take this boat.
All right. Depot number 5.
Number 5?
Yep.
Number 5 is alive.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and use my 5.
You've seen that movie, haven't you?
Yeah.
Short Circuit.
With the robot, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen it. You showed it to me one night.
Number 5 is alive.
I'm going to go ahead and put my chickens in. So that will give me 4 points. 2, 3, 4. And I have 3. Let's go ahead and take the sheep from 3.
Yeah, I'm going to use this 2, and I'm going to take the castle.
Okay.
And then I have a 6. I'm going to use that 6 to put this knowledge right there. Okay. That's going to give me bonus points for boarding houses, which you have boarding house.
Yep. So. All right, depot number 5 for that.
5 is loading up.
Yep. Let's see. I'm going to go number 5, take that mine.
Oh,
and
man.
And with 3, I'm going to put that mine right there.
Ah, crud. I should have taken a mine.
Well, you didn't.
I usually am on top of that. I can't believe I didn't do that. So you're done?
I'm done.
Okay. Not the dice that I was looking for.
Wasn't?
No, they were not. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of this 1. I'm going to get 2 workers.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use my 2 workers to make that 6 into a 4. So that is going to allow me to sell this good. So I'm going to get 2 points for that. But more importantly, I get a silver.
So you're going to go to the market?
I'm going to the black market, pay my 2 silver, and I'm going to take these cows.
Alrighty. That was that.
So that is the end. We each have a mine, right?
Yes.
So we each get a silver.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, get rid of those tiles. I will put the new market tiles out. Is that it?
Yep, that's it. All right, good on depot number 6. And let's see what I want to do. I'm going to go to 2, take that castle, and use my worker to make that 6 into a 5. Put that castle right there, so that gives me an extra turn.
And that completed it.
That completed it, so I get 1 point from that.
Plus another 6.
Yep. Right there. So I get 3 turn. I'm going to go ahead and put my sheep on the board.
And that's 2 points.
That is 2 points. Sheep. Yep. Thank you.
And do you have that knowledge in play?
I do.
No, the knowledge, it gives you a bonus.
Yeah.
So you're actually going to get another one, another point.
I should have did that for the chickens, too.
Okay,
I didn't
so give yourself
it.
An extra point.
I know, I didn't do it, yeah.
That's fine.
I'm not sure when I placed the pigs, but I'm not going to count for that. I'm already ahead of you.
Don't rub it in. okay, I am going to use this 5, and I'm going to place my boat.
All right, so you actually get to jump ahead.
I'll put my boat there.
You get to go first now.
And I get to take all the goods from one depot.
There's
I think I might as well do this.
Yeah.
Because there's 3 there. So 2 like, I'll put that there and there. And then with a 3, can I do anything with a 3? I wish I could. What's over there? Oh, you know what? So I'm going to use that 3. Pigs in a blanket?
Pigs in a
bank. I'm going to take the city hall.
City hall, yeah, not bank.
City hall's good. All right.
Bank's the other one. All right, you're first. So you get to roll the white dice.
So it's going to go back into the 5.
Okay.
So 6 and a 4. Uh-huh. I can do this. I'm going to play my 4, put my city hall there. So now that I've placed my city hall, I can play an additional 6-sided choice into my state. I'm going to place these cows right there. So since I already have 4, I'm adding 3. That's 7 points. So would you kindly give me 7 points? I've completed a 2 section, so that's going to be an additional 3. And I get 6 points for this round, or this phase.
All right.
Okay.
Catching up.
Yeah, and then my 6, I could take a bank or I could take more cows. You know what? I think I'm going to take this bank. And that's it.
Okay. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and use 2 workers to make this. Actually, just 1 worker to make that 6 into a 5. I'm going to go ahead and take this knowledge tile. And with my 2, I'm going to go ahead and put that right in there. That completes a section. So that is 2 points for that. And then another 6. So right up there to 80.
Which one did you just complete?
This.
Oh, your knowledge?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, so that is the end of that.
Yep.
So that's going to go to 4.
Okay.
So a 6 and 4. So I think I'll use my 4, and I will place my castle right there.
So that actually completes a section.
So it gives me 1, and then another 6.
Mm-hmm.
And now my free action, what do I want to do?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you're going to do.
Something that benefits me.
Something that benefits you. Why would I want to do that?
Because you're a kind father.
I am a kind father.
Who lets his daughter win?
I think I will use that, and I'm going to place this city... For this bank, we're going to put the bank. I think I'll put the bank here. And that's going to give me 2 silver.
Okay.
Now, with my 6, let's see. I think I'm going to go to the black market. I'm going to pay 2. I'm going to take this watchtower.
Okay.
And then with my, I don't have any workers. So, do I want to take the cows? There are only 2 cows. And I can't sell anything. Or do I want just workers? You know what? I think I'm just going to get 2 workers.
Okay.
So that's it.
I'm gonna go to 5 and take that mine. And I think I'm just gonna use that 3 and take 2 workers. Okay.
All right, that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is gonna go on 6. So 6 depots loading up. So 5 and a 3. Let's go ahead and let me see what's on the board. You took the mine.
I did take the mine.
That was my mine.
No, it's mine now.
Mine? Well, I'll use a 5, and I'm going to place my watchtower. And I'm going to place it right here. So that's going to give me 4 points, please.
Okay.
And then with a 3, I don't really want the pigs. I don't really want to do that. You know what? I'm going to use a worker, and I'm going to turn that 3 into a 4, and I'm going to take this warehouse.
You didn't do what I thought you were going to do, so I'm really happy.
Which was what?
Take the boat. Yeah.
I thought about it.
I'm going to go ahead and use a worker to make that 5 into a 6, and go ahead and put that mine there. That is a 2 section, so that gets me 3 points, please.
1, 2.
And another 6.
3, and take ship to 9.
Woohoo. That's it.
Wow. Whoops.
Oopsie.
And since you just... would you? Oh, you placed a mine.
Yes.
You took the boat. You didn't place the boat.
No.
Okay, so
let's
go on 5. So I have a 4 and a 2. I don't even want that knowledge on the there.
You have a worker.
I do have a worker. I'm going to do this. I'm going to place that.
Sell your goods.
I'm going to use that 2. Well, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to use that 2. I'm going to place the warehouse there, which will then allow me to sell a good of my choice. And I'm going to sell these. So that's going to be 4 points, please.
Okay.
And a silver. with my four. I don't want the pigs. I really wish I had another building to complete, but I'm just going to get two workers.
Okay. Let's see. I think I'm going to go ahead and use the six and take the two cows and use one worker to make this four into a five and put that cow there, which will give me 2 points. And that's that.
All right, so that is the end of this phase. Mm-hmm. You have two mines.
You do.
I have one, so you're going to get two silver. I'm going to get one.
Okay.
Did you get your silver?
Not yet.
Yeah, don't forget your silver. Place these out here. Okay. So we're all good?
Yep.
Okay.
Number two.
So. This is going to come back to haunt me, you getting those in there when you did. You know, I got to do this. I got to get that mine while I can. You still got one spot open, don't you, for mine?
Yes, I do.
And then a six, I am going to take... Ooh, six, I think I'll take the sheep.
Sheep?
Take them sheep. That's four sheep.
I thought you were trying to say ship. Like the sheep.
Oh, and do I want to go...
Like how we say fish.
No.
Dude, you slapped a fish.
Yeah, that's four sheep. You know, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go, and I'm going to spend two silver, and I'm going to take these other four sheep.
All right, then.
Because that's a lot of sheep.
Yeah, that is a lot of sheep.
That's it. I'm done.
That's it? You sure?
I am sure.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and pay two silverlings, go to the black market, take a castle, use my one, put that castle right into play, give me a bonus turn.
So you've completed the section, right?
Yep, so it's 1 point.
One, and then another four. One, two, three, four.
So I get a bonus thing there. So I'm going to go ahead and place my ship right there. That gives me another 1 point.
One, and another four. One, two, three, four.
It actually gets me to move right up in front. And then I still have my six. So...
That was a pretty good move.
Yes, it was. I'm going to go ahead and take the church.
All right.
Okay. So I'm first.
Oh, yeah.
Aha. Good on number three, please. Let's see. I'm going to just go both to one, actually. And just take both of those. The boat and the boarding house.
Okay.
So it's my turn. All
right. I will use the... Whoops, that was a... This was a five. I meant to grab the five.
You're fine.
That was a five.
I trust you.
Yeah.
I wasn't watching, but I trust you. I might, probably shouldn't.
So with my five, I'm going to place these sheep there, and that's going to give me 4 points. So one, two, three, four. And then with the three, I'm going to place this mine right there, which will complete this. So I'll get, whoops. I'll get 1 point for that, and then another 4 points. So one, two, three, four. And that is my turn.
All right. Good on number six. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my six and put, let's see. I'm going to go ahead and put the church right down there. So that lets me take a mine, a...
Knowledge or a castle.
So
you have a watchtower bonus, mm-hmm. knowledge, and I don't know what that other one is over there. And
it's then, if you sell your goods, you get two gold or silver ring.
Oh, instead of one.
Yeah. I'm gonna do the castle, and then with my one. Just gonna take two workers.
Okay.
There we go.
My five, I'm actually going to take this knowledge, which is rare for me to do that.
It is.
But I do actually have two watchtowers out. And you know what? For the two, I'm going to place that knowledge right there. So, get a little end game scoring. So that is the end of that round.
Yep. Good on number six.
Six is filling up.
It is. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and... I kind of have to do this a bit differently than what I wanted, but it's okay. I'm going to use two workers to make this two into a four. And I'm going to go ahead and put that boat, so that is completed one, and another four, so 5 points, please.
It takes up to 106.
Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to go ahead and use that worker to make this two into a three, and I'm going to take those cows. I don't think I used my bonus again on this one, so one more point, because I'm pretty sure I didn't when I put it over here.
I don't think you did either.
All right, thank you. Okay. I forget about this when they're not in the game. It's like, oh, yeah, that's a thing.
So you're done?
Yes, I'm done.
All right, I'm going to use this one, and I'm going to place my sheep here, which now I have 8 sheep there. So that's 8 points.
Gosh.
So just made it 89.
That's pretty good. You're catching up.
And you know what? For 4, I'm going to take this boat.
All right. Good on number 6.
Wow.
Ooh, I can do what I want, I think. Not quite, but okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my 2, put my cows there, so that will give me 3 5 points plus some 1 for that bonus, so 6 points in total, please.
So you're going to get 4 for that one there.
3.
Well, you got...
4, yeah, because of the
bonus. So you get 4,
bonus.
And then another 2.
Another 2.
So you get 6 total.
6, actually, yeah.
Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
I might have said 5, but yeah. Then I don't have any workers do anything with my 4. I'll go ahead and take this building right there.
Well, I'm going to do this. For 5, I am going to place my boat up here. That's going to let me take all the goods from One Depot. Oh, you know what? I live in number 6. Let's see. I don't think I can actually... I can take this one.
Yes.
And I'll take these two. And then I gotta choose. You know what? Let's do that. Yeah, let's do that one. So those have to actually go back because I can't use them.
Yep. Okay.
So now I have a 4. I could sell because I can't really do anything. So I think I will. I'm going to sell these 2 goods. So that's another 4 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that will give me 1 silver.
All right.
So that is the end of the phase, actually.
Aww, it is.
So... we get our silver. I'm going to get 2. You're going to get 2. All those go away.
Yep.
Last round, last phase. I'll put these out here. Okay, you're still first.
Yep. Good on number 6. 5 and 3. Ooh, I can do what I want to do, I believe. Nice. I'm going to go ahead and use my 5. Put my castle there. Get an extra turn. I'm going to go ahead and put my boarding house there. That will give me 4 workers. That completes a section. So that is a 2 section for 3 points, and then another 2, so 5, please.
Okay.
And then...
well, when you placed your castle, too.
Oh, yeah, I should
so
have
another...
so you
get 1 point for that, and then another 2.
Yeah, awesome, thanks. And then I'm actually going to go to the black market, take those chickens, and use my 3. I completed all my castles, actually, so I should get this bonus. And then I'm going to complete all of my pastures, so I get that bonus. But because of my chickens, I now have 7 chickens.
So you're going to get 3 for that one.
3, 4, 5, 6,
no.
7, 8.
Is that 3 chickens?
3 chickens.
Oh, so you get 4
3,
for that,
4, and then
plus another
4
is 8?
Yes.
So it takes you
and
to
And I
29.
Got those bonuses.
Okay, so now you completed your pasture.
Yes.
Which is a, how big?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
That's a 6. That's 24 points.
21.
Or 21 points. So there's 1 and... holy cow, kid.
That was a good one. That was what I needed to help pay off.
As the late, great Bill Paxton would say.
Game over. Man.
Wow.
We've been saying cows.
We have been saying cows. Cows is a Twister reference.
It is.
Are you quite done pummeling me?
I mean, for the time being, there's still 4 more turns left, so we'll see.
I was going to do this. I was going to complete that so that I could get that bigger bonus.
Ha ha ha.
Dang, kid.
That worked out really well. I wanted to do it last turn, but it's good. I still got it.
Now I don't have the incentive as much to do that.
You just lost all the will to win the game.
So, I gotta do this. There's a 3. I'm gonna use 2 workers to make that 3 a 5 so that I can take this, mine. And then I'm going to use my other worker to make this 2 into a 1. And I'm going to place that mine there, which will complete my 1 section. So I get, woohoo, I get 1 for that.
Woohoo.
And I get another 2.
But you completed all your mines.
Because I completed that. And then, yes, I will get that at least.
I was so close to getting
it. So that's for end of game. And I've got silver. There is a bank and that. You know what? Don't want to do that. No, I don't. I'm gonna. Oh no! You want? I do want to do this. I'm gonna pay 2 silver, and I'm going to take this market.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'm done.
Alrighty. Get on depot 1. I'm gonna go to 6 and take this building.
That's the carpenter's workshop.
Yep, MFA 3, I'm gonna go ahead and put that in there.
And that will let you take another building from here, which would be, yeah, you get your choice. Remember, you can't build the same building in the same city.
Yep, I'm good.
All done?
All done.
Okay, I'm gonna use my 2 and I'm going to place my market right there. And I can take an animal, so I'm going to actually take these pigs.
Okay.
And then I have a 3 left. Use that 3 and I'm gonna take a warehouse. And that's it.
Alright. Good on depot 1 again. Alright, let's see.
These aren't the dice I'm looking for.
Let's go ahead and use my 4 to put my marketplace into play. That is a section that will be completed for
3 points,
and then add an extra 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then that actually lets me take a pasture or a boat. I don't need any more pastures, so I'm going to take the boat.
An animal, really.
Animal, yeah.
To go in your pasture.
True. And then I'm going to go ahead and use 2 of my workers to make this 1 into a 3. And go ahead and put that boat right there. That moves me up a jump. And that will give me another...
That also completed your boat area.
No, I still got one more.
No, but I mean...
So
you're going to get another 3 points.
I get 3 points, but I mean, I still have that one to go
for. 1 for the completing the section and 2 for that.
Mm-hmm. And that's it.
Okay, I have a 1 and a 2. Not the greatest. So I'm going to use my 1, and I'm going to place my warehouse over here. And that will allow me to sell a good type. So I'm going to sell these 2 5, so that's going to be 4 points. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, I'm at exactly at 100. And with my 2... Yeah, with that 2, I'm going to take this castle. Because it is castles of Burgundy.
It is.
All right, so that's it.
All right. Good on depot 1 again. Keep rolling those. Let's see. I am going to go ahead and make a worker. Turn this 5 into a 4. Take that boat. Use my 6 and complete my boats. Haha. So
you're going to get 3 points for your boat. 1 yep. for the area and 2 for the...
Yes.
For the phase bonus.
Mm-hmm. Puts me there.
And then you took the big marker, big bonus tile. I am so dead. You're almost going to lap me here.
Yeah.
You're quite done.
I am quite done. You get like posh when you get upset during gaming.
Posh.
Posh.
Posh
kind of
spice.
Proper. I don't know about her.
Alright.
Which one was posh?
She's the one that's married to David Beckham.
Okay.
I hate to do this. I gotta turn that into two workers.
You know, for as much British stuff I know nothing about the Spice Girls.
Well, they were a little bit before your time.
Just a little bit.
So, with those two workers that I got, I am gonna use one, and I am going to make that five into a four. And I am going to place my piggies here. So that actually gives me eight pigs in total.
That completes all your pastures.
So that's going to put me up to there.
So you can get the tiny bonus.
So it does complete my pastures. But that's a four section, so that's actually going to be 10 points. So that's going to put me up to 18. Woohoo! And that is it.
All right. Last turn. Good on number five. Let's see. I'm gonna go ahead and use my one and just sell that good for 2 points and take a silverling. 2 points, please. Actually, I'm over here. Never mind. I was looking at my boat, thinking I was over there again. And then my six, I really don't need to do anything, so I'm just gonna.
I actually should be up another one.
That's cool. And I'm gonna take two workers just because.
Okay.
That's it. I'm done.
You're done?
I'm done.
Okay, let's see if I can do something good here. So I'm going to use this three to put this castle into play. So that completes that one section. So I get 1 point for that and another 2 points. And now I get a free action. So with that, I want to take this church. And then with my last one, I'm going to place that church here, which will complete my section of four there. So that gives me 10 points, which puts me to 31. And the church. What's the church do again? Church gives me...
Mine, knowledge, or castle.
There
which,
no...
There's only two knowledge left.
Okay. Well, it really doesn't matter because I'm out of dice.
Yeah.
I'm not going to have any more turns. So, just for grins, I'll just take that.
Okay, that's it.
That's it.
Now
so...
I'll do end of game scoring and get back to you with the winner.
Yeah, I have a feeling it's not going to be me. Okay, yeah, this wasn't even close. Megan almost had 200, and I didn't even get to the 150 mark.
I have had 200 scoring games before, though.
Yes,
so
you have.
So I am pretty good at this game.
So, yeah, so we got points for, I actually had two watchtowers, so I got 8 points for that. I got a couple of the completed tiles. You had
15 points just in that.
Alone. Yeah, that's good. And then... Yeah. I got a point for my unsold good and a couple points for our
silver.
Unsold silver or our remaining silver.
Yep.
So, yeah. So, here's your trophy, kid.
Yay.
Now, let's get to what we think. Well, I guess we'll let winners go first.
Yep.
And that was a very deserved win. You played a very good game.
Mm-hmm. This game is really good. Though it's probably not one of my favorites. Although I do really like it when we do kind of get into it. It's just probably one that I'm not probably going to take off the shelf that much. And that's nothing to knock the game. It's just one that I'm probably going to be like, yeah, okay. I probably feel like I need to be in a certain mood to play this game.
Now, let me ask you this. Because, and those of you who have watched know that Megan is a spiteful daughter. Because any chance she gets to stick it to the old man, she does. Is it because there's really not that much take that in this game?
I don't know, because, I mean, you can hate draft in a sense, depending on your roll of the dice, but you're kind of limited to that in a sense, but...
Because you really have to play your own game, I think.
Yeah, you do. You can't really be too focused on the other player, because, like, you can have a different, like, you know, your starting mat, so you're going to have a different arrangement, you're going to have a different goal of what you need to get more of in certain order and stuff, which I think it's nice that they have the variations of the player boards, because I know, like, with the first map... or the board, it's the same. And you have, like, I think four of those just to start you off.
Yeah, the first map, it's Well, I don't even know if I don't know if that I even say it's basic. It's just everybody has the same layout, and I think that's the point.
It's somewhat basic because, I mean, you have a good starting point if you put your castle here, because then you can kind of branch off into everything and then start going off.
Well, that's what I did with mine, because mine, I actually have the castle.
You have it in the middle.
In the middle. There's a close-up of my board there.
Mm-hmm. And then with mine, I just put my castle up here and just kind of worked my way down. But, I mean, I like how you kind of have, in that sense, you do have your own game. So it's not as much of a, you know, trying to get the same things that your opponent might be.
There's a number, like this one here.
That one's a lot of.
This is number two. But look, I mean, you're going to be starting on the edge because you always start with one castle. And since you have to build next to it, this is very, very varied.
Yeah.
But look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the
largest
area you
can
have. Yeah, that's 36 points if you complete that.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
So, I mean, there are different strategies for this. There are a lot of replayability. It is kind of just luck of the dice with whatever you roll, but that's not necessarily a bad thing, I think, because I think it gives you different options and also can deter kind of some hate drafting.
Well, and you've got enough of the worker situations that come up to mitigate that problem.
Mm-hmm.
So anyone who says, you know, they don't like this game because of the dice part, you know, really they've taken steps to mitigate that.
Yeah. I mean, not much else for me, I guess. You can go.
Okay. I really like this game. And, you know, I've played this with my work group now. I think I've played it with three or four. I can't remember which, and I think I mentioned that during the gameplay. In a two-player game, I think this plays really fast.
Mm-hmm.
There's not as much thinking. You don't have as much downtime. The turns go very fast. You know, so I really like that aspect. I like components. I think the player boards, they're I don't want to say they're wimpy, but they're good. The artwork on the cards, it's very nice and clear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've got the legend over here, but I still have to actually refer to the rule book, which the rule book I actually like, because one of the things that they do, I mean, they spell out what each of the buildings do, and I constantly have to look at that,
because
I'm old and forgetful.
I could kind of see that being somewhat of a knock, but not totally, just because there is so much iconography, so it's a lot, I think, for beginning players just to kind of take in. But you do have a really excellent rule book that will just spell out exactly everything that you need.
The thing I like about the rule book is on the right hand side of the page, they tell you basically, hey, here's the down and dirty. This is what this does. Now, if you want to, you know, get a little bit more into the explanation, then you can read over here. But this tells you, here we go, the church. You can take a mine, a knowledge, or a castle from the display. From a depot. You know, the market, you can take an animal or a ship. So that spells it out. And it does that throughout the entire rule book.
Well, and especially the last couple pages are for the knowledge.
Yes,
and it's really nice. The knowledge tokens do have a little number on the bottom. So you can easily just go to the rule book and consult it.
That is a good point. And that, that is, you know, one of the things that makes that a good rule book.
Yes.
You know, this has got a lot of variability because you've got... There's a bunch of extra market tiles that you don't even use.
No.
So you're going to shuffle those up. And so those are going to be, you know, I realize the market stuff is not that big of a deal.
No.
But that does give you playability. Of course, you've got your variability because you don't know what tiles are going to come out.
You do have a good stack of those tiles. And we shuffle them and then we just pop them on the board.
And then the other thing I want to point out is the game scales very well because you'll notice... you've got, you know, areas for four players and three players and two players. So, you know, the more players you add, then the more tiles you're putting out. So I really like that aspect. And I know we showed this off in the unboxing, but I'll show you. The game comes with all these little baggies. So
we cannot Gerber it.
This game cannot be Gerberized without taking the insert out, which if you wanted to, you could easily do. Although,
insert,
you know,
though.
these the tokens here,
full Gerber anyway.
Yeah, these are very small, so they don't take up a lot of room. It just, the game does have a lot of setup time, and that can be seen as a negative by some. It's not really that big of a deal. You know that going in, there are plenty of other games that have plenty of setup. So, in my opinion, because the game is so good that, you know, that's something that easily... overlook. But I really enjoy the game. I like it. Highly recommend it.
Definitely.
So that'll do it for Castles of Burgundy, the board game.
Mm-hmm.
Now, watch our video on Castles of Burgundy, the card game. And at the end of that video, we're going to basically talk about the pros and cons for each, you know, why we like one over the other, or, you know, what are the strengths of this one over that one. So more of a comparison. And we specifically did not do that in this review because we wanted this just to be the board game. So we'll do a full review of the card game. And then at the end of that, then we'll do a comparison. So that is it. And we will catch you guys next time.
Bye.
If you would like to support us, you can visit patreon.com/dadvdaughter.
Like and follow us on Facebook to stay current on our show schedule, sneak peeks at future shows, and interact with us.